Off-page SEO isn't just about building backlinks, it's about building relationships. From leveraging niche communities to crafting collaborative content, there are many things that you can do to gain backlinks, recognition, and establish yourself as an authority. So in this video, we're going to talk about all the off-page SEO strategies to help you achieve your goals. Take note of the last one because McDonald's did something out of the box a couple of years ago which can help you out, and we're going to talk about that. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMap, the one SEO plugin that empowers millions of WordPress sites, and this channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, subscribe. So we have said this multiple times on our channel that there are different stages to growing your website, and if it is still in the infancy stage, you shouldn't worry about building backlinks. You should be working on things that you can control, such as content creation. If you haven't watched this video right here where we have talked about all the different stages of your website and what you should do at each stage, I highly recommend that you check it out. The link is in the description. Anyway, assuming that your website is somewhat established, let's talk about the off-page SEO strategies, starting with this. Crowdsourced resource pages are content-rich pages created by gathering input, data, or insights from specific communities to address common challenges or interests within a niche or industry. For example, if you are a fitness marketer looking to boost your site's authority, you will first join fitness forums, Facebook groups, LinkedIn, or even Reddit threads. These are places where people are actively discussing topics related to fitness or your niche. After browsing and analyzing these communities, you realize that people struggle to stay motivated for fitness in winter, which gives you an idea. You create a survey asking the community how they stay active during colder months, and after receiving hundreds of responses, you compile the data into a polished resource page titled The Ultimate Winter Fitness Guide, Tips from 500 Enthusiasts, completed with visuals and a downloadable workout tracker. Once the page is live, you reach out to everyone who contributed, thanking them and encouraging them to share the guide. And because it benefits both the contributors and their audiences, they will naturally link back to your resource page. And as more people find value from your crowdsourced resource page, the number of natural backlinks will keep increasing. So by solving real pain points and involving contributors, it can help amplify your reach and authority. You don't need to be an expert to be an authority. Hope you find this helpful, and if it is, do help us out by smashing that thumbs up. Now, let's move on to the next strategy. If you have been in the SEO space for a while, I'm pretty sure you have heard of this strategy, and it still works for established sites. What you would do is to discover the broken links an authoritative site is linking to, analyze what these contents are, and create them as a replacement resource, and then you reach out to the authoritative site and ask them to link to your contents instead. For example, let's say that I wish to get backlinks from WP Rocket. I will go to the free Ahrefs broken link checker page. This is the link. I will add WP Rocket's URL here, and let's check for broken links. And now it will provide me with a list of broken links WP Rocket has been linking to. And then what you want to do is to analyze the broken links. What you are looking for are content-rich articles that has become a non-existent page, marked as 404. So for example, this gives me an impression that this page is talking about TLS certificates versus SSL. If this topic fits your site, you want to create it. And if you want to see the contents of this broken link, you can leverage the Wayback Machine to see if there are any snapshots of how the page looked like. But just take note that sometimes you won't find a snapshot. But normally, judging by the URL, you can gauge what the page is about. So using that topic, you want to create the content. And once the content is created, you want to reach out to WP Rocket and ask them to replace the resource link on this page to link to your content. The other thing you can do is to check out the broken inbound links, which are external sites linking to WP Rocket, where there are pages on WP Rocket that do not exist anymore. You can do the same thing. Analyze the broken links, create similar content if it makes sense to your site, and reach out to external sites if they fit your profile as authoritative. Micro-influencers are individuals who have a social media following typically between 10,000 to 100,000 people, and they specialize in a specific niche or industry. For example, Shana Mayerson, who has a following of about 24,000 on Instagram and almost 50,000 subscribers on YouTube, and yoga brands such as Yogi Surprise and Mandukar have engaged her to create content for them. Such as if you search for Yogi Surprise on her channel, Shana has created some unboxing videos for the company. When micro-influencers influencers start to recommend products, their followers who own websites or social media accounts will start following suit and you will earn backlinks from there. Unboxing is not the only type of content micro-influencers can do. There are sponsored posts, how-to or tutorial content, lifestyle integration content, before and after transformation, collaborative content creation, and many more. I'm pretty sure if you're in the business, you know who the micro-influencers are in your niche or industry, so go reach out to them. Collaborating with complementary, non-competing brands expands your audience, builds credibility, and generates high-quality backlinks. This creates win-win outcomes and improves off-page SEO. For example, HubSpot partners with Wistia, which is a video hosting platform, to co-host webinars and virtual events about video marketing and inbound strategies. If you search for Wistia and HubSpot on Google, you will see that both companies share the promotional workload and use each other's audiences. Wistia customers will check out HubSpot, and the same goes for HubSpot's customers. This type of collaboration will result in high-quality backlinks from webinar registration pages, event recaps, and blog posts. So try to figure out which brands are complementary and non-competing, and you want to start reaching out to them. Social media outreach used to be a chore. On top of creating high-value content, you have to take some time to draft your social media posts. But with the help of AI, you can now draft your social media posts in no time. For example, as a RankMath user, you have access to a wide range of AI tools. Simply hover over RankMath SEO, and you want to click on Content AI. If you do not see this module, you have to visit the dashboard to activate it. Anyway, let's visit the module. And here are all the AI tools available to you. As a RankMath user, you automatically have 750 credits per month for free to use these tools. But if you need more than the free credits, you can get one of the Content AI subscriptions. Anyway, the tools for creating your social media posts are in the marketing and sales category. As you can see, you can have the AI create Facebook posts, a tweet on X, Instagram, email outreach, etc. So let's say that we have written this article about SEO for brand awareness, and we want to create a Facebook post for it. So we can go back to the Content AI module, select the Facebook Post AI tool, give it a topic brief such as entice people to click and read the content about SEO for brand awareness. You can select your audience, add a focus keyword if it makes sense, and since it is a Facebook post and hardly anyone searches for content on Facebook, we will leave this empty. Then select your writing tone, such as informal, friendly, casual, and conversational. Choose your content length. The short option will produce 1-2 sentences. The medium option will write about 3-4 sentences. And the long option will provide you with more than 5 sentences, which is what I need. Select your language. As you can see, there are many languages you can choose from. But for our case, let's keep it as US English. Then if you want to have several outputs to choose from, you can adjust it here. Let's say that we want 3 outputs. For your information, every generated word equals 1 credit. Let's hit generate. Give it a while, and it will start writing your Facebook post. And here we go. What do you think? Which is a better output for you? Let us know in the comments. If you want to find out more about how to use the other AI tools I've mentioned, you can check out the links in the description. There are 2 off-page SEO tips to help boost your local SEO. The first is leveraging localized PR, and the other is utilizing geo-specific social platforms. When we talk about localized PR, it involves partnering with regional publications and journalists, like local newspapers, blogs, or online news outlets that cover topics related to your niche or industry. To find localized PR opportunities, you can use platforms like MarkRec. When you sign up an account with them, you will have access to their search function where you can search for people, articles, and media outlets. Now let's say that you are in the fitness business and you are searching for potential journalists to do a piece on your business. You can include a keyword such as fitness, add your filters if they make sense, and you want to search by location, say Singapore. And let's do the search. And here's a list of potential journalists. You can click on one of them and view their full profile. And if you're serious about connecting and building relationships with these journalists, you will sign up to MarkRec's premium account to make contact with the journalists. And if you are a journalist yourself, such that you are a blogger in a particular industry, you can join them as a journalist and put yourself out there. This platform works either way. Now, the next strategy for local SEO is leveraging geo-specific social platforms like Meetup or regional forums to connect with people with similar interests. Go for events, share your knowledge, answer questions, and participate in discussions relevant to your niche within these local communities. Social proof refers to customer reviews, testimonials, or public acknowledgement that validates your brand. While UGC or user-generated content are content created by your users, such as photos, videos, or blog posts, that showcases their experience with your product or service. To leverage them for off-page SEO, you can create a dedicated page on your website featuring customer success stories or case studies that demonstrate how your product solved a problem. For example, we have this dedicated page that showcases all our customer testimonials and success stories. These pages not only improve trust but also become linkable assets. If you do a backlink check on this URL, you can see that this page has gotten over 2,000 backlinks with 98% do-follow links. So if you have received testimonials from your customers, you definitely want to create a dedicated page to showcase them. On top of that, we encourage our customers to share a short video of their experience with our products, and we openly share them on our YouTube channel. Such as when you visit our channel, check out the shorts. And as you scroll below, you will see that we have received so much love from our customers and we really appreciate them. This not only helps with off-page SEO, but it also helps with improving your brand's reputation. On top of all the online strategies we have shared, you can leverage offline strategies as well. The first is community sponsorship. If your brand has the capacity, you can sponsor community events like festivals, charity runs, or educational seminars. For instance, Patagonia, a popular outdoor apparel brand, sponsors various environmental events and initiatives, such as tree planting campaigns. And in return, they receive a ton of backlinks from non-profit websites, environmental blogs, and news outlets that cover these events. The next offline strategy will be offline guerrilla marketing, where you would use creative, unexpected ways to grab people's attention. Things like stickers, public art, pop-up shops, etc. And you can encourage people to share content with branded hashtags, generating online buzz and backlinks. Let me show you one creative example from McDonald's. Heard of Scream for Ice Cream? Let's check this out. This happened in Singapore a couple years back, but I think this is probably one of the most memorable campaigns. So if you have a dedicated page on your site that provides all the instructions and details about your campaign, it will naturally attract a lot of backlinks. So these are all the off-page SEO strategies we can share. And obviously, if you have any other strategies to chip in, feel free to do so in the comments down below. And if this video is helpful, how about helping us out by smashing that thumbs up? Our channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. And if you're new to us, consider subscribing. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.